Hello, welcome to Bad at Board Games. My name is Brad Lake, and I'm bad at board games, so you don't have to be. Today, we're going to be looking at a GameFound crowdfunding campaign, the sequel to Tigris and Euphrates, which is the sequel to Yellow and Yangtze, which is now the sequel of Reiner Knizia's Huang. Yeah, that. Unfortunately, the English language does not pronounce that correctly. And I probably will not be any better. So let's take a look. Why do you want to stick around to the end? Maybe I'm going to back this. Maybe I'm not. Let's look at the value of it. Are they trying to stick it to you because it's the old classic that people want? Are they giving you a good deal? I don't know. Let's take a look. So we have a goal of 30,000 euros, and we're already at 102,679 euros. So came out pretty good. It's not a very long campaign. Just started this week, and we've got about 5 days left. So was it like a two-week campaign, maybe a little bit less? So they're definitely like feeding into the get it now. Don't miss out. So a little bit of FOMO, but is it worth it? So this is a Reiner Knizia game, classic. You know, I think Yellow and Yangtze, you have to pay scalper prices and such. You might be able to get it cheaper now that this is coming out. Or they're going to jack the price up until this does come out. Don't know. In an ancient land, distant rather, where rivers of blue and yellow dare not meet, the seven rulers fought one another for one to lead them all to defeat. The emperor to humble them all, one emperor to subdue them, one emperor to unite them, and under the crown behind them. That is not stealing from the Lord of the Rings and Tolkien there at all. No. All original work there. You're going to lead a kingdom dreaming of an imperial throne, and you will establish new states, build pagodas, and strive for influence and strategic advantages. All that is highly involved, struggling using original mechanics invented by Reiner Knizia. Okay. Buy back now. We've got GameFound backers will receive an exclusive Dragon Dynasty. Two dynasties. In case the first one wasn't dynasty enough for you, we're going to dynasty it up again. A set increasing the player count to 5 for free. They gave you like a few extra things. You're paid for it. Available on GameFound only. Exclamation mark! Because it makes us more serious when we use exclamation marks. Or angry. Go easy on your wallet. Don't lose and pass up this chance for a bargain. They're saying it's going to be 55% off of MSRP. I don't believe that. I don't think they're going to sell this for over $100. Make sure to get the game before it appears at retail. And then we've got people saying, it's great. It's wonderful. You should buy it. All right. Deluxe Pledge. We are going to get 59 euros, which that's really decent. I thought they were going to jack this thing up. I thought for sure this game was going to end up being $120. You know, Reiner Knizia, and it's an old game. You can't get it anymore. And I don't know if they're not necessarily Queen Games-esque with what they're doing, but, you know, I expected this to be more. So I'm pleasantly surprised already. And that's with the miniatures, which is this isn't a miniature game and you don't need miniatures. So you can get that for $59, and then the standard pledge is 45 euros, not dollars. Don't know if they have the conversion factor anywhere on here right now. I will look that up as we talk. And then they've unlocked the fifth player expansion, so I'm guessing that's what this is there. And then you can buy a double-sided play mat. And then the Royal Palace, you can get you know, just something to, like a marker that goes on your table for $7 that costs less than a buck. And the wooden leaders set for $12. I don't know how you use those. That's kind of nice. Nothing expensive. You get to build your basket and then try to get you a little bit more involved and get a little bit more profit out of it. And it doesn't cost them much to ship this. The playmat would cost more to ship. Weight and size and everything, depending on if they fold it. So what's in the box? So the deluxe edition, we've got a double-sided linen board. I'm assuming that just means linen finish. My first thought was that it was actually like a, you know, piece of fabric, which would be kind of cool, but I think it would wrinkle up too much. So I'm assuming that's a linen finish cardboard. Then we've got, you know, the typical hidden screens. And then we've got a canvas bag. And then these look like better, maybe larger, better looking versions of like the, if you played Castles of Burgundy, the tiles that they have there. Hopefully these are a little larger so you can see them a little bit easier. They don't have any reference for how big they are. So all those little tokens, 5 sets of miniatures, leaders, and then in the deluxe edition, they're still going to give you the standee versions. I kind of like the standee versions. These almost look like they're wood. I wonder if they are. It doesn't say. I don't know if these standees are going to be wood or cardboard, but that looks like it's like a laser cut wood that's printed on it. I'm sure it's not going to be laser cut. That's not a high speed manufacturing kind of thing. And then we get some unification markers, pagoda miniatures, pagoda standees, and 19 greenery miniatures. All right. And the standees. So this is the deluxe edition. And then the standard pledge comes with cardboard elements. It does not include plastic miniatures of pagodas, leaders, and unification markers. So it is cardboard. So those, all those standees that look kind of like thick and like they would be some kind of wood printed standee. They're not. They're all cardboard. So essentially with the regular pledge of Huang, you are going to get a playable game that'll be very nice. 2 to 5 players, but it was originally made for 4. And you can look up a gameplay. Sometimes I don't appreciate it when people go into the mechanics because it kind of gets boring. But let's see what we're paying on shipping. The U.S. and Canada, €16. I wish they had the conversions for each. Like, what is €5 for in Poland? What's €5 in U.S.? What's €5 in, you know, wherever else? Let's see. I don't know where my conversion factor is. I want to see what the current rate is. I don't want that. Sorry for the side tangent. We need to know. So €1 is 1.07 US dollar right now. So it's not much more than this. So the dollar and the euro are about even right now. $16. That's not bad. It's for those of you who've been following some of my Kickstarter rants a little bit about shipping and Wonderland's War and them charging me $18 for cards. They have come back and said they're going to credit like $7 back to us and that he doesn't make money on shipping and they lost their shipping provider and had to switch and all this, but in the end, I that was a little bit excessive. Somebody didn't negotiate well enough or what, but when you're trying to charge me $18 for like 2 card expansions, just go to the US mail and put it in the $5 box. Not horrible. They're not really telling you a ton of stuff. We've got, I guess I will talk about a little bit about the tile placement. You're going to build out your army or your control. Try to overtake other areas that are on the board. I'm interested in this game. Why am I interested in it? Because it's one of those old classics, and you don't get, you know, scarcity makes everybody want, like, oh, I want that, right? So I want to try it. I want to play it. Haven't had a chance to play Yellow and Yangtze. Our Derek has in our game group. He doesn't care for it. But then you look at Liege, and like, this is one of Liege's favorite games. So you kind of like want to make a decision for myself, right? And if they've got the rules, which is nice, they're already published. You can go on Tabletop Simulator and play it. See if you're interested in that. We've got Game in a Nutshell. I already saw some comments on his. I like his videos a lot from Nitharnia. And someone's saying like, oh, you already got this wrong. And I don't know. Drama. And all these kinds of things. I don't know. I'm not, probably not keeping you too entertained at the moment. Tantrum Con. I went to their convention. I liked that. Not sure about their channel. Hit and miss for me. 2 minute overview. Why would you want something in 2 minutes? Let's talk for an hour. It's board games. Give it all your time. They've got a lot of people going on. Mr. Knizia, there we go. Lots of people, lots of pictures and media. All right. Is it worth it? What is our value rating? Let's go back to pledge levels. So, you are going to get this deluxe package for 59 euros, which is not much more in US dollars. So I'll just leave it. I'll put the actual calculation, but I mean, 7 cents times 60, 65 dollars, 63.20, something like that. So for $63, you're going to get a few miniatures, double-sided board. You know, you're in that range of the current Castles of Burgundy, right? Like, except you are actually getting some miniatures with it. So the current Castles of Burgundy, this is kind of where I lump these classic Euro games into. You can get for that $50 range, but it's all kind of cheap and thin and great gameplay, but it, you know, production value is way better on the current one than the previous one. And then the GameFound's new version of Castles of Burgundy is going to be like all and everything. And I've done a lot of all and everything on that, but not all of it. So I think out of a 1 to 5, if this were $40, I'd absolutely give it a 5, right? Even if 30, anything below Castles of Burgundy prices, I would say this is a 5 out of 5 value, no doubt. And when you look at, and we'll get to the standard pledge, but the deluxe pledge has more, so I wouldn't expect it to be in that same price range. So I think this is a really good deal, actually, for what you're getting based on current prices. Now, the shipping is what's going to make it worse. So, like, if I just had to go into the store and pay $60, $63 for this, I would be very happy. But if they're putting, I think they said $16. Let's see, $16 shipping, almost 20. And I have to calculate that in because that's where some of our hits get taken, right? So if we're at 63 plus 20, you know, you're 83, then that's where it starts to, is this worth $83? You're getting close to Cthulhu, Death May Die, and all the miniatures that you can get in that game for $85, $89. Then this is nowhere near the production value of like the CMON but that's been out a little while, and that's why the prices are dropped. That was normally like $100, right? I still think this is a decent deal. I think, you know, if this were $150, this would be a value of one. It's not what you're getting here is, yeah, you know, it's nothing fabulous. They're trying to make it a little bit of table presence, but you're not going to walk by this table and be like, oh, wow, I'm blown away by how great this looks. You're getting this for the play. $60-$80 feels like it's a little too cheap for 80 some bucks. So I would say I'd give it a 3.5. I still think it's a good deal. I think it's better than average. You know, I would buy this all day. I think I might get this. But you know, I don't think it's like the best deal you're ever going to see, and you should just realize that. So just understand what you're getting into there. Now the standard pledge with the $16 or $20 with the upcharge, not going to be that much, but I'll put what the real shipping is after the calculation in the little screen thing that I'm doing. Gosh, it's early in the morning. So 45 and 70, let's see, 10, 40, 28. We're less than $50. So $48, $49 for this plus $20 in shipping. You're up to $70. Now, by itself, I think this is a great deal without the shipping. Like, I would almost say this is a 5 out of 5 without the shipping. It's right where I want it to be. It's like, you know, because it's in that range with Castles of Burgundy and, you know, looks a little nicer, I'd happily pay $50 for this all day. Or wouldn't be upset to pay $50 for this. So I think they've priced it right. Then we're being loaded down for the shipping. So I think this is a 4. I would give this a 4 out of 5, you know, because shipping is what shipping is. I don't know if this is going to retail. I don't see, reasons to get it. Usually they say there. You get some Game Found exclusives. Don't care about the 5-player count. I don't believe them at 55% MSRP. I guess if that's true, then this would be a reason to get it. I would not pay $100 and something for the deluxe. So it is going to go to retail based on that comment. So they're saying before it appears in retail. So going to retail, my guess is this standard pledge is going to be around this, so you could wait and get it for a decent price. But then if you don't, you know, if you don't pre-order it, and sometimes these things are hard to get. Look at Heat, right? This isn't going to be, you know, as popular as Heat. You can tell by the Kickstarter numbers already. $100,000 is nothing to shake at, but it's also not, you know, blowing up $1 million. This is an old classic Euro, and you have to like those and be interested in those and kind of want to play those or get those played, kind of check them off the box. But reasons to get it. I am going to back this game. So right now I'm leaning towards the $45 pledge because of shipping. I don't think I'm getting anything more in the deluxe that I can live without. The miniatures, and I love miniatures, but this isn't necessarily a miniatures game. I could play this with plastic, or I could play this all with cardboard pieces and not even standees and be fine. You know, these are the older Euro games. So, but I think I would be happy with the standees, and that way if I don't love it, I won't feel like I overpaid for it. And if I think it's great, then I'd still be happy with what I got. So I think it'll play just fine. So I am going to back the standard. I am not going all in. Raw, which is coming out soon from 25th Century Games, I backed all of that. I got all the thick wooden pieces and things like that because I'm way more invested into that game. I really want to get it to the table and own it, and I can't own it because it's like $200 on the scalper, you know, unavailable. So I was glad to deluxify Raw, and I was glad to deluxify Castles of Burgundy. This deluxification, I think, it's all right. I don't think it's great. And so I'm just going to go with the base. And there you have it. What do you think? Are you interested in these older classic Euro games? I know this one isn't. It's a sequel to Tigris or Yellow and Yangtze, which is a sequel to Tigris and Euphrates. But like Yellow and Yangtze's, 4 years old, something like that. Not super old. And then Tigris is older than that. What are you interested in these older games? Just like, man, I don't care, you know? So what's your interest level of these? I guess I'll know by how many people watch this. but I think it's slick. I think it's worth the money and for what you're getting. Now the experience that you have with it may prove different, but I have set my stake in the sand, so to speak. I hope you enjoy these. I enjoy making these. My name is Brad Lake, and just remember, no matter how you play, whether you play solo, with family, or friends, enjoy whatever you are bringing to the table. Have a great night.